Welcome to Show Nupur.
Hi, thanks.
Again, this is mandatory.
I'm going to say namaste.
Yeah. It sucks, you know. It sucks that usually when I receive my guests, right, at the studio, either if I know them properly or there are like bear hugs or there are high fives
or handshakes.
For the first time ever, there was this distance.
I know, and
people are being wise now that, you know, namaste.
Yeah.
It's been, have you heard of any, you know, like, did you come up with any cure or something of your own? What are you doing besides fucking sanitizing your hands?
Sanitizing, washing,
yeah.
Not hugging people like you're doing. Yeah, just not. And trying to maintain a distance. Mm. And if someone's...
It's wise.
Yeah.
You're in control, right?
Yeah, because see, my job is with people. Whether it's at the Pole Studio or at Mr. Rabbit's, we are interacting with people all the time. So you have to be careful.
Yeah, and especially at your bar, it's like absolutely social, right? And if you are those kind of, hosts
who
actually go out and, you know, meet people, if you have made friends.
Yeah, we've made friends, and plus we go to each table, we interact with customers, we serve them.
Are you being the rude host right now?
So many people come and say hi, and I'm like, namaste, touching, yeah.
But it's fair, it's fair.
Yeah, it's good. I saw a video of Prince Charles doing namaste, so I'm like, yeah.
Everyone, this guy came up with Ramdev, like Baba Ramdev.
Uh-huh.
I'm a fan of that guy.
Okay,
I don't know about the stuff
he can do is amazing.
Yeah, sure. But
I'm
more of a fan of his, you know, the things that he tells about diseases and diet and all that stuff.
Okay.
I think that's very real.
Okay. Yeah,
because, you know, it's not, people say that it's, you know, witchery or whatever. People don't believe such people. But I think he talks sense, and he has been talking about Ashwagandha, you know, Ashwagandha, the herb. So he's telling people to have that. Why? Because, COVID-19. Yeah? So this has proteins.
Okay.
And the proteins in this virus, they attach to your proteins. And the only way to separate these two and prevent further combinations or, you know, all this thing, you need Ashwagandha. That's his deal.
Okay.
And I would like to get on board.
Yeah, why not? It's not going to harm you.
Exactly.
You know, when this whole thing happened, and I think our government put out a thing that we should turn to homeopathy and Ayurveda,
people made
a lot of fun of it.
They do.
Yeah, but I'm totally with that, because that's just going to help your immunity. That's what we need right now.
At the end, I think that's all one needs.
Yeah, exactly. You have your immunity is strong, you have lesser chances of falling sick.
I don't know many cancer patients, but I think even if... I don't even know whether I'm making sense right now, but even if you have cancer and you're fighting cancer, I think immunity is the foundation, right?
Everything.
If you bring that up, maybe you'll fight it for longer.
Yeah,
right?
Of course.
God knows.
It's everything, yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, let's just talk polls.
Let's talk polls.
Get to polls. I think the only one in Pune, right?
Yes.
Only one in Pune.
Yes. I was the only one, but now my students are polling.
Right.
So we're like a nice
polling.
Small...
Is that a term or did you come up with this?
No, polling. Everyone says that.
Polling.
So yeah.
You also call yourself a pole athlete.
Yes. Yes.
So here's where it gets tricky for me.
Yeah.
Are you going to compete?
Yes.
Ever? Perfect.
Because there are
championships, right?
Yes. There are championships the world over in different countries. India is still behind, but I'm pretty sure we will start because we have started the Pole Federation in India, which is now affiliated with the International Pole Federation.
No way, there's a Pole Federation in India.
It's very new, so they still need to get out there and do stuff.
Right.
So I'm waiting for that.
But yeah, so I'm just thinking that people from all over India, from different states, are playing rugby.
Correct.
And rugby isn't there. So, pole, which also has a stigma attached to it.
Yes,
like
yes.
Massive stigma,
of course,
right? To have Uska Federation, I think it's amazing.
Yeah.
I will personally promote it if there's a federation.
You should
for
start
it.
Pole too. Because guys the world over are doing it. Guys.
I saw that. And
they're
amazing.
Because as guys, you all have natural, stronger upper body strength than women. We have to work harder.
I agree.
But it's for everyone. So there are guys who do the exotic dancing as well.
That's where it gets tricky for me.
But I don't do exotic dancing. No? I can't wear those high heels and do it because I look like a frog.
Say that because I've seen the pictures.
No,
but
it's really difficult to dance and do those pole tricks wearing those really high. They wear 11-inch high heels that are specially for pole.
Okay.
And when I watch them, it's just so amazing because it takes massive amount of strength and body control and flexibility. And I'm just like, wow, maybe someday after years of practicing, I may get there.
Because I saw a dude wearing tights and heels.
Yeah.
And you know what? He was brilliant on that.
Yeah, they kill it.
It was. So here's the thing. Another, so you said that I should do that.
Yeah.
That will never happen because I know myself, right?
But you're into MMA, right? Like you like MMA, so you like sport.
Yeah.
So you look at this as pole sport, which is what I do.
Here's the thing. Huh. So a lot of pride and vanity comes in the middle. So I'm like that since forever. Even if I tell myself.
Yeah.
So I'm that kind of person who will, you know, lip balms are for guys and all. It's okay. Yeah. I'm not the one who's going to carry a lip balm in my pocket and take it out. And otherwise, there was this person who I knew. So she was promoting her brand and she was like, you know, try this. It was a good product. It was a good product. And she wanted, you know, guys can use it. That's how she wanted to come out as a brand, right? Positioning that. It's a unisex brand.
Correct.
So she was like, use it. I'm not going to use it. Because I know myself, right?
Okay.
But
I'm going to get you to come into a class. Just so you know how hard it is and just how you know what a kick-ass form of fitness it is.
I'm all up for that. I'll give it a shot.
Free class.
Yeah. That, you know, I think I deserve it.
Yes.
But thing is that if you tell me to do all the, you know.
No, so you would do. You
effeminate
would do,
moves and all. I might not be able to do under say.
Exactly. So no, I'm not saying you have to do that. You know, even I don't. Like, if you see my, when I'm doing spin pole, I do make it look graceful because that's me.
Right.
But each one brings their own style to pole.
I agree.
You can make it look strong and just like, whoa, what is he doing? Like, that's amazing. You know, so each one you have to bring your own style to it, your own personality into pole. So
still might not do it. I don't know.
In class, no one gets it.
For that, I'm sure. As long as you're not recording.
Okay. For now, okay.
But here's another thing that I really want to tell you in person. That is like, you know, people think pole dance.
Yeah.
Of course, it looks very sexy.
Yeah.
It looks hot.
Yeah.
So when you are doing it, it looks hot. But what people don't realize that is it's fucking extremely difficult.
Yes.
It is insanely difficult.
It is.
You know, to even, and what you are doing, you also say that you are the only person, only girl who can do a proper flag.
I think so. In Pune.
You would like to think so. You would like to think so. I think you are one of 5% people on this planet or 10% who can actually do that. Think about it. I've thought about it.
But a lot of polos can.
I'm just saying compare with the population, right?
Yeah, yeah.
It's amazing. Yeah. It blows my mind away that, you know, people take it lightly. It's not that easy. And to make it look graceful, that is where I don't know. Just tell me about your routine. I want to know. I have a lot of questions.
So how
did it all begin?
So I started, I wish I'd started earlier, but I just didn't find a teacher in India at that time. And when I did find one, this was while I was working with the Times of India. I was deputy editor with Pune Times.
Right.
So I found a teacher in Bombay. She would teach at Dadar. Uh-huh. So when I contacted her, like asking if she would come to Pune and, you know, teach, she said, you find me a studio and 10 girls and I'll come.
What's her name?
I don't remember her name.
Okay.
You know, this was way back. This was way back. So that didn't happen because I asked my girlfriends and they were like, no, what is this? We don't want it.
Yeah.
We don't want to learn. Because like you said, the stigma attached to it, you know. But so that plan fizzled out.
Right.
And then I quit that job. I was into footwear design. I had my own label. I got married. I had more time on my hand to, you know, do more stuff like
footwear
fitness.
Design?
Yeah, I'm also a footwear designer.
I mean, I know that, but how does that work?
So I loved shoes and I wanted, shoes were my life.
Yeah.
Like, I couldn't have enough of them. And I really was intrigued about how to make shoes and stuff like that.
Shoes.
Yeah. So,
like proper deep cobbler science into it, like, you know, actually make
actually
from scratch.
Make, yes.
Okay,
yes.
Sweet, sweet.
So anyway. I went to London to study footwear design. I did a short course.
No way.
Yeah. Came back and my husband told me, you know, like if...
this was after you got married.
I did the course before.
Okay.
But just before we were getting married, I was in two minds whether to quit my job.
And pole didn't happen at that time.
No, pole had not happened at that time.
Cool.
So he told me, like, you know, if you don't do it now, you look back a few years, you know, later and be like, why didn't I? So
lucky wife.
Yes. I am very lucky because he is my strongest support system.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
So so I quit my job and I started my own label, which did really well for 3 years. I did well for myself.
What is it called?
Nupur Chaudhary.
Nupur Chaudhary.
Yeah.
Footwear.
Yeah, footwear. Okay. And but then in the middle, Paul happened.
Right.
And I started driving to Bombay to learn. This was another teacher in Malad. And unfortunately, I had like a wrist injury.
Okay.
And Paul, so it's like any other sport. While you're playing badminton, while you're running, you can get hurt.
Right.
Right. So I had a wrist injury. So I had to stop Paul and other things. And that's also at that time that we started Mr. Rabbits.
Right.
And I really wanted to be involved like fully with the project because it was my husband, my brother-in-law, me and my mom-in-law.
Just because people are listening. So I want you to tell what Mr. Rabbit is since you're talking about it. Because if you say Mr. Rabbit, people might
know. It's like a little gastropub in Baner. So we wanted to go with the idea of making it into a very cozy neighborhood bar.
Right.
That you want to chill at. It's your home away from home, and we've done everything ourselves there, like my husband Ashwin and my brother-in-law Kunal.
Right.
They've designed the place themselves. We got everything made in-house.
But do you kick stags out?
No.
Perfect.
Everyone's welcome. Nice you are welcome in Chappals.
Oh, really? Really?
No dress code. Yeah, it's your home. So you think of it like your home bar.
It's called Mr. Rabbit, right?
Mr. Rabbit.
Mr. Rabbit, guys.
Yeah. Mr. Rabbit's because we have an entire wall painted by Ashwin and Kunal with the whole Alice in Wonderland theme.
Okay. That's where the name comes from.
Yeah.
All
that's
right,
where the
right.
name. So all I named it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Yeah. So my mind just
rabbit
got...
Hole then. Okay.
So that was the initial name, by the
copyright
way.
Issues?
No. Another place opened in Delhi or Bangalore.
Okay.
The Rabbit Hole, and just 2 weeks before us.
Okay.
So that's when we came up with Mr. Rabbit's Bar and Baru.
Right.
So yeah. And it's at the at the bottom of this little hill kind of a thing.
Right.
So it actually feels like a burrow.
Yeah. Okay.
So
anyway, getting back to
So I got really involved with the bar, and with my wrist injury, I couldn't do much. I couldn't.
Right.
So my workshop for my shoes was in Bombay. I would drive there and stuff. So that came to a sort of a standstill. My exhibitions came to a standstill, and because that break happened, I didn't really get back into it.
Into footwear.
And but 10 months later I did once my wrist recovered.
Do you plan on, you know, just resurrecting the whole project?
I think I'm just so into pole, and I think I found what my soul was looking for.
Perfect. Makes sense. Yeah.
That I
no
don't
need
think
to
I need anything else in my life right now. So yeah, that may not happen. Yeah. But it was a good run while it lasted.
Yeah.
I enjoyed myself and I made some good shoes.
That's because you're the first person who I've met in person who actually made shoes for women.
Yeah, for women.
For women.
Oh, for women.
Works, huh?
Yeah. So, that's...
So, another brilliant idea.
Yeah.
You're into poles.
Yeah.
And after, let's say, 5 years, you are massive in India.
I hope so.
I hope so too.
Yeah.
So you should come up with the footwear related to pole, right? Nupur Chaudhary shoes.
The high
for pole.
Heels,
yeah.
which I look like a frog in while dancing.
You don't have to be the model for that, right? So that's where you have to tell yourself, okay, I'm not going
to
model.
Now
for
I
it.
Need to step back. But who knows, I may be exotic dancing 5 years down the line.
See, because I still can't relate to it when you say that I'm not exotic dancing. Because when I go to Instagram for poles, when I see all the ladies, including you, that is as exotic for me as, I don't know. I'm sure you guys aren't wearing high heels and bikinis and doing it the way other dancers do outside.
So, so exotic does have that sort of a dress code and the high heels. And it mainly comes from what the strippers do. So, I have utmost respect for them because, like I told you, it's so hard to do be doing that.
We'll get into that. I want to get into the,
yeah.
you know, how body reacts to the pole. That's one of my major fears.
Yeah,
like
you see my body, I have bruises all over my body.
I have no doubt.
And my husband does not beat me up, guys.
This is my with the black eye. I don't know. Shit. That's dark. Anyway. But getting back. So your shoe designing took a back seat.
Yes.
So poles, you were learning. I also saw Dubai trips.
Yeah,
over.
So when I wanted to get back after 10 months, I wanted to sort of... not be at the same, I really wanted to increase the level that I was at, you know, because I'd just done four or five months.
Was teaching ever in your mind? Or
no,
you
no, at that time.
You just wanted to learn.
Teaching was not.
What was the reason behind learning? Because, you know...
Yeah, so...
Why did you want to learn that?
So, of course, when I was initially attracted to pole, you watched Demi Moore in Striptease.
Yes, that's the first thing that comes to your mind when you say
she did that. I was like, wow, I want to be able to do that.
When we got this thing locked in, right, that I'm going to sit with you, that was the first thing that I was thinking about. That did she get inspired by Demi?
Yes, I did.
Yeah?
Absolutely. So it's been on my mind since then. Like, I want to be able to do that. Like, that looks amazing.
Very sexy.
Yeah.
Sexy in a very powerful way.
Of course, so powerful. Yes, yeah. And when I went for my class, you realize that your basic fireman spin or a fire lady.
I don't know what that is.
Yeah, I'll teach you. So basic fireman spin is so freaking hard.
Okay.
To be able to keep your body away from the pole, to be able to grip just with your ankles and hold your body weight up with your hand. That when you're able to do it, it's like, fuck yeah, I did that. My body did that. You know,
just like flag or muscle up, any achievement. That
yeah, so I'm working on my pole muscle ups right now, and I'm making progress. So
pole muscle ups.
Yeah.
How the hell do you do that? Because it's horizontal in a way.
No,
right?
We hold and you lift from your hip and your core. Yeah.
But where do you muscle up? Like
you muscle up from here up, so you have to go up.
Okay.
Yeah.
You're holding the pole like this, right?
Yeah.
So how do you go?
Yeah, exactly. But I'm making good progress.
Wow.
So maybe once I'm done, I could put up a tutorial.
Yes, please. Yes, do that.
So every little thing, like when you climb the pole the first time, you're like, oh my God, this is so hard and I did it.
Right.
So that keeps pushing you to do more, to want to learn more, because you are sort of defying the limits that your mind has set.
Just like any other craft, right?
Yes.
Yeah, perfect.
Yes.
Nice.
Yes.
Nice. So, here's the thing. When you said that it's, you know, the bruises part is, you know, that metal thing has, is it a polished pole? Like,
so, it's a stainless steel pole.
Right. But what's
you
the coating?
You get some with chrome coating as well.
Right.
But mine is just stainless steel.
Okay.
Yeah. So, you do slip.
Right.
So, which is why we wear the clothes we wear. You cannot pole...
That was the question. But is there a coating that helps reduce that abrasion?
You do get different poles.
Okay.
Okay. You get the chrome plating, which is grippier.
Right.
Yeah. Then you get even silicone wraps.
Okay.
Yeah. I've never used those. Mm. I've always used stainless steel.
Silicone wraps on the pole.
Your grip is really good. And then you can pole even with clothes on. But then for you to do different transitions is really hard.
Okay. Here's the thing.
Yeah.
So, of course, I've seen many videos.
Yeah.
So... So when the dancer is on top and they do this fake fall, right?
It's not fake fall. You actually fall and you grip the pole. So I can do those too. You do drops.
Yeah, drops. So I mean, so why I call it fake is because, you know, when they are in shows like, you know, You've Got Talent, blah, blah, blah. So audience goes like, ooh, and all.
Yeah.
So they kind of fake it that they're falling and then they catch themselves.
Yes.
That's why
it's called a drop.
Drop. So terminology, my bad. I'll call it drop.
Yeah.
So when they do that.
Yeah.
So and they grab it with their inner thighs.
Yeah,
right?
Or your legs. Yeah.
So
knees.
If that's the science behind it, and when they're falling and they're grabbing their entire body weight with their thighs, their inner thighs should look like like a gymnast's hand, like cones and calluses and
so
all.
So that doesn't happen when we get bruised. You get friction burns.
Exactly.
Yeah. So you do get it, but over time your body gets if I keep doing that move, I will no longer bruise from that move. But if I try a different move, I will bruise.
Okay, but so the spot isn't an issue. Like, for example, on this spot, you get rubbed again and again and again. And then it just, there are no calluses, right?
No, there are no calluses. But if you see, I do a lot of shoulder mounts. So you will see.
Okay.
Yeah, you'll see.
It looks like you're into fight or something.
Yeah. So that happens. So with me, shoulder mounts, I get bruised no matter how many times I do it.
Right.
But that's my body.
Okay.
Some girls don't get it.
Alright.
Yeah.
Alright.
So with drops, you do hear that sound also of the friction, but it doesn't really
scary.
Burn that much.
Really?
Yeah, it's just the sound. But yeah, and drops are fucking scary.
They are
scary.
And the entire weight sustained by your thighs, there has to be friction.
Yeah. So now you think it's thighs. Yes, we're gripping with the thighs, but also your body is so tight. You're actually engaging every muscle to be tight. So your core comes into play, your upper body is strong.
Right.
So actually, it's your entire body keeping you up there. Yeah. So that's why I say with pole, I think we use we tend to use muscles that we don't normally use while doing a normal workout, maybe.
Yeah.
You know, you target these other tiny muscles and stuff that you don't generally use.
So tell me about this. So when we do a flag, I've tried it once or twice. Again, insane.
Yeah.
So your core gets involved.
Yeah.
It gets involved absolutely, right?
Yeah.
And of course your shoulders and all everything.
Yeah.
So you do the same thing on poles.
Yeah.
And you take your legs, pull out.
Yeah, so I do not do the flag directly from the ground. I have not really tried it.
Right.
So what I do is we go into a handspring. We call
okay.
it a handspring.
So you push the ground and you take your legs.
Yeah, so now I can even deadlift into that
okay.
without kicking up.
Right,
so,
right.
you know, these are tiny progressions you make.
Sure.
Yeah, so you go up.
Right.
And from there you descend. So it's almost like a negative.
Hmm.
Yeah, that
that's
you're doing.
How they even train people to do flag,
yes.
right? So that you get
so
used
that's
to
the training I do, and
right.
that has really helped because
hmm.
a few months ago I could barely hold it for like say 2-3 seconds.
Hmm.
Yeah, and the other
respect.
Day, the other day I held it for 6-7 seconds.
Okay.
So for me that was like really good progress.
Yeah, because
yeah.
even my when Anavi told me about,
yeah.
shout out to Anavi.
Yes, Anavi, thank you.
So Anavi told me about. She said that you should get her. Like you,
okay.
you know, she's. And then I went to your profile.
Okay.
And my sister also saw that. My sister
okay.
is into CrossFit and all. She's
okay.
also, she's a strong girl.
Yeah.
So she when she her mind was blown away.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because
oh, wow.
flag
you.
Is, you know, I consider myself to be very, you know, I have that endurance, cardiovascular,
yeah, yeah.
blah, blah, blah. I think
yeah.
that. But when it comes to flag, because I've tried flag
yeah.
and all,
yeah.
it tells you that, you know, stay
exactly.
down, you're not made for this. It tells you.
Yeah, you're
so,
actually fighting gravity.
So
yeah.
what I want to know is, are there any points of contact when you're doing it? Poles. For example, since I've seen a lot of videos
yeah.
again, so pole dance videos, so even the touch of the toe to the pole,
yeah.
it's like it's aligned, and if you don't do that, the whole balance will, you know, you'll collapse or something. Is
so
it that
I
intricate?
I don't touch the pole during a flag.
Right.
Yeah.
So, like for example, there's this move where the dancer is holding the pole and the legs are up.
Okay.
So of course your core
yeah.
is engaged.
Yeah.
But there comes a time when they touch the pole with just the tip of the toe.
Okay, but is that for flag?
No. I'm just
oh,
dance,
in general.
Dance. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Different
ah,
moves. Different
yeah,
moves.
Different moves. Yeah, sometimes you have to hold the pole with just the toe.
Yeah.
That gives you that grip, you know, that
okay.
contact point.
Balance, yeah.
Yeah, it gives
ah.
you that balance for certain moves.
Right.
And then you can split with your other leg, and even so, you're just on your toe
ah.
and here
right,
on
right.
the pole.
Yeah. Yeah.
yeah? So think of me upside down like that.
Okay. Then, yeah.
yeah, and
I
then you can split
down,
and
yeah.
hold your other leg into a split. So that's like one example.
Okay.
But yeah, so...
So, a lot of girls...
Yeah.
I think girls... so, I think it's different the way a guy looks at a girl pole dancing and
yeah.
a girl... The way a girl looks
yeah,
at a
sure.
girl pole dancing. Because
sure.
when you see the reactions of men
yeah.
in those videos, right?
Yeah.
So, they are all like, oh, I want that woman.
Yeah,
most
yeah,
of them.
Yeah.
Because
of course,
she's
yeah,
looking
yeah,
amazingly
yeah.
sexy,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And the girls, they have that look that I want to do that.
I
would do that.
Yeah.
I personally think girls love pole dancing.
Yeah.
They love it. They love it.
I think, you know, all the girls who I've met
uh-huh.
and who compliment me or
right.
like, wow, you're doing amazing stuff.
Yeah.
So many
are,
of
yeah.
them, so many of them have also revealed to me how at some point they have thought in their minds that, oh, I want to learn pole dancing.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
So, yeah.
That brings me to the obvious question that when you started, what was the heat, what was the backlash, like okay pole dancing,
luckily
from your in-laws, parents, whatever,
yeah,
your
so,
brother
my brother said it's a fad, so yeah, now I think he's eating his words, but
yeah he should
yeah, but so no, because it was very new, right?
Yeah.
So everyone thought, oh, what
still
is this pole dancing
is.
Still is
yeah,
yeah. It still is. So my dad needed a bit of convincing,
mm-hmm.
I think.
Fathers, yes. I
yeah.
Don't blame, I don't blame
him. Why does she need to do all this
yeah.
pole dancing? But but yeah, I think he is secretly and sometimes not so secretly very proud of me.
I'm sure.
Because the other day I was showing him my muscles and he was just like, wow. yeah. You know, and sometimes I show him my videos and he's like, it's amazing. But then
yeah.
he'll also in the same breath be like, I don't think you should be doing these things upside down. The blood rushes to your head. And
tell him that is good. Haven't
yeah,
you
it's
done
okay.
yoga? And
yeah.
Stuff, yeah.
No, I think he's just worried because I've injured myself.
He's
before.
Just finding excuse to tell you not to do it.
Yeah, I know. But yeah, he is proud
yeah,
of me and
sure,
what,
sure.
what I can do now.
Yeah, he should be.
Yeah.
I think more girls should get into this.
Yes.
More girls,
more girls and guys
yeah.
need to get
yes,
into
yes,
it.
Yes.
Yes.
All those who want to.
Yeah.
Yes.
My mom-in-law has been super supportive.
Fantastic.
So she would get excited to see my videos after each pole class that I went to. So I would come back from Bombay, drive back, and show her, this is what I did today. I did the chest spin, I did the fireman spin, I climbed the pole, and she would be like, wow. You know, so she has been very supportive. I'm very lucky to have a mom-in-law like her and a husband like Ashwin, because I think we need that support system.
Yes.
Especially in India, because we have that whole thing of log kya kahenge.
Yeah, we're still growing. We're still growing.
We're still growing, and sometimes people don't understand why we have to wear pole wear.
Right.
You know, you have to, it's like when you're swimming, you are going to wear your swimming trunks. I am going to either wear a swimsuit or a bikini, whatever I am comfortable in.
Right.
So same with pole, if I wear slacks or whatever to cover up, I am going to slip and fall, and that's going to be dangerous.
I'm waiting for the time when you, maybe you won't do it personally, or maybe you will, but I'm sure you'll get into exotic pole dancing and you'll get others to get into that.
Yeah.
At that time, you'll have to wear fucking bikinis, right? And
exactly. And so, you know, so right now, because of pole and my husband's support and his respect for what I can do, the kind of clothes I wear and what part of my body I'm showing does not bother me at all.
I think what you said is really important. That's a very important point that, you know, your husband's respect towards what you do. That matters. That matters.
It does.
Yeah.
So it just doesn't bother me. So earlier I was, I used to be very conscious because I have some stretch marks on my upper thigh, down my butt or whatever. Right. So I would never wear a bikini also because I'd be like, oh, what are people going to think?
Now you don't give a fuck.
Oh, I just don't give a fuck. Yeah. Cellulite doesn't matter. Yeah. Skin coloring doesn't matter. Yeah. You know, it, and the stretchies, it doesn't matter because I can do this shit. Can you? No. So
exactly.
Keep your mouth shut.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Makes all the sense in the world.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So that way.
Another thing that you told me.
Yeah.
Was that you're cleaning your poles because of the coronavirus with fucking vodka?
So not because of coronavirus.
You've been always cleaning your poles with...
with vodka.
Okay.
With so I sanitize the poles.
Alcohol, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that
it's
makes sense.
It's the best. And
agreed.
It's
but
cheap.
Since you were very specific, right? Vodka. I was
I use vodka.
Okay.
The Russians use vodka.
Okay.
Yeah, and the Russians are amazing at what they do. So.
Another question. Are Russians the best pole dancers in the world? Because I think so.
I think they are.
I think so. Because all the videos that I see, mostly they are Russian girls.
They are, I think.
And men.
You know, they start when they're 6 years old. Yeah. So, I have like this pole idol, Dmitry Politov. Like, I hope one day I can
train. Dmitry has to be a dude.
I hope one day I can train with him. So, I always say I'm pretty sure he's half alien, half human with the kind of stuff he can do.
That happens when you have a crush on someone.
Yeah, he's my pole crush.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
That sounds nice in different levels.
Yeah, it's just amazing what he can do. And
I'm sure.
Yeah.
What's his name again?
Dmitry Politov. You can check him out on
Dmitry
Insta.
Dmitry Politov. We'll give him a shout out.
Yeah, he is. Oh, he's amazing.
Nice.
Yeah. So, it's, the Russians are the best.
So, they use vodka to clean their poles.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because Russia, vodka, cheapest.
Yes. Stereotyping. But
sense. But yeah. And you can use other cleaning agents, but since now it's a class.
Plus, you have a bar, so I mean it.
No, but I buy it from the wine shop.
Now you're lying.
Yeah, no, I'm not lying. Of course I do.
You're not even maintaining receipts for them.
No, I do buy them from the wine shop. I go and say, sabse sasta wala vodka de.
What is it though, I say?
Hayward's Classic Vodka.
I remember Romanov. There was this.
Romanov also.
Yeah, yeah. Have you ever had Romanov?
No.
No?
No,
what are you doing? You're missing. It's like a vodka ka desi thara.
Ah, okay.
Gives you a fucking insane hangover. Like bad. Like it's like you've attended a rave like for two nights and you've just had four or five drinks.
Okay.
Yeah, that kind of headache. Yeah, it's bad. That's when I used to drink. But oh my god. Bad.
So coronavirus and cleaning poles with vodka works the best.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
And what's this? I really owe you because you are lean and fit.
Yeah.
Your diet?
Vegetarian?
So
I'm vegetarian. I eat eggs.
Okay.
Yeah, but I think eggs are vegetarian. So because...
Ooh, we're going to have a problem with that.
If you keep the egg for 3 years, it's not going to hatch. It's...
Veg still doesn't make it vegetarian.
No, it is vegetarian.
Comes out
I
of
would love,
bum.
I know. But soap milk comes out of a cow. It's still vegetarian.
No, it's not vegetarian.
These are unfertilized eggs, right? So there's no baby in there.
So it needs a chicken sperm to be non-vegetarian.
Yeah, I guess. It needs a baby in there to be non-vegetarian.
I'm not gonna criticize that.
No, I
that's
think
your
so.
Belief.
No, I think I just
belief,
I
right?
just read up on it, and this is what I read, and
yeah,
because I did try not eating eggs in the middle, but then
animal source of vegetable. Can we call it like that?
No. Let's say I'm an vegetarian for now. I would love to go vegan because see, I was non-vegetarian.
Huh.
I've been vegetarian for 10 years now, vegetarian for
okay.
10 years
okay.
now, because I love animals.
Right.
I
love animals.
Yeah.
But I also love some of them on my plate as well.
I know. So a lot of people do, and
yeah.
that's a personal choice.
Yeah.
Yeah. Each one to their own.
Right.
But me personally, I would not want to eat eggs as well.
Right.
Or I don't drink
because
milk.
Because of the
but
unethical farming that you're talking about.
Exactly. You know, all of that.
Yeah.
So I don't want to be a contributor to the cruelty, which I am right now.
Right.
But I hope someday I can go vegan. It is hard.
Hmm.
And I try some days, you know,
yeah.
to be. So that's what I can do.
Hmm.
But that said, so my diet, I do eat eggs at
hmm.
least maybe 3 or 4 times a week.
Okay.
And I do take whey protein.
Right. But you don't look like that, you know, someone who's very rigid with food. I don't know. I might be wrong.
No, I eat dessert every day. So.
No, not like that. But, you know, some people are totally into it. Okay, this is my meal time. This is my shake time.
Oh.
This is my. You don't look like
no,
that.
No, I'm not.
Yeah.
I'm not.
More like, you know, I need to cover my calories, but yeah.
Yeah, and I eat when I'm hungry.
Exactly.
So if
yeah,
I'm hungry, I'll eat.
That's very
yeah.
important.
Yeah, and
that's
if I'm not
important.
Hungry, I will not force myself
hmm.
to eat.
Right.
So it's like that.
Okay.
Yeah, so, and my afternoon meals are cooked by my mom-in-laws.
Okay.
She's amazing, I told you.
Okay.
So I don't know how to cook. So
right.
she's an amazing cook. And
not even survival food?
I don't know how to cook. So I have this fear of fire, so which is why I never learned. I can't even light a matchstick. So, yeah.
I want, you know, let's pause everything. I want to talk about that. How did that happen and what
I don't know. I don't know.
No?
No, I don't know. I'm just very scared of fire.
Of fire, just like that?
Yeah, yeah.
Since childhood?
Yeah, I'm just very scared.
There must be something, right? Some trigger, some memory, or maybe something you saw in a movie that at a very
know.
Young age, that
I don't
like,
know.
No more fire.
I don't know. Where
so, you
it
run
comes
away
from.
Or like don't put that up?
Yeah, I don't like it near me.
You smoke?
No.
Not at all. Have you ever?
No.
No. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
When I was 14, my dad did give me a smoke and his whiskey, and he said, try both.
Okay.
Because you will eventually.
Your father offered you a cigarette.
And
drinks,
and
most of the fathers do
yeah,
sometimes.
And I could not smoke. I hated it. You don't know what you're doing at that time, right?
Yeah.
And
technically
so that's my memory of smoking. So
yeah.
I never touched a smoke in my
okay.
life. I quite like the alcohol. So
yeah, yeah.
I did drink. I do drink sometimes now, off and on.
Right.
But very rarely.
Hmm.
So yeah.
So it's eggs and it's normal food with your whey protein.
Yeah, normal ghar ka khana.
Right.
And my dinners are at Mr. Rabbit's.
Right.
If I want a
every
pizza.
Day?
Yeah, every day. If I want a pizza, I'll eat a pizza.
I don't want a bar.
But I try and sometimes do like salads and eggs on
right,
certain
right, right.
days. And sometimes it's pizza, sometimes I'll eat something off the menu.
But it's majorly sticking to dal roti chawal wala khana.
I don't like dal roti. Yeah, I don't like dal chawal. It's not my comfort food.
Okay.
I love paneer.
Okay.
I love bengan. Bharleli wangi. I love that.
Oh, what was that?
Bharleli wangi.
What the hell is
yeah,
that?
It's a Maharashtrian dish and it's damn amazing.
What is it made of? Like, what is it?
It's bengan. With this lovely masala. I don't know how to cook. Don't ask me what it's
no,
made.
No, no, no. But it's bengan ka dish.
Yeah, yeah.
It's called?
Bharleli wangi.
Is it the bhartha that we call
no it's
girl?
Not bhartha but I love bhartha as well. Yeah so, I love
so you're a bangan girl basically.
Okay yeah and I love chola, I love rajma,
huh.
I love all this kind of
right,
stuff
right.
But you give me plain dal rice, I'd be like too boring.
That's what I really wanted to know, like, you know, home cooked food where you
yeah but this kind of home cooked food I like.
Yeah, because people are now you know, not inclined, was they're going mad after all this, you know, healthy food, so-called healthy food, where it's just a bowl full of greens and microgreens and
yeah.
Know,
so I don't mind salads.
Yeah.
I actually enjoy salads.
Right.
Yeah, there was a time when I came back from Dubai because I was doing only salads and eggs over there.
Right.
Because I don't know how to cook, so
right.
I was going to Spinney's and going to their salad counter and, you know, getting my lunch.
Right.
So, there was a while where my body could not digest Indian food after I came back. I was getting major acidity and stuff.
For how long did you stay there?
I just stayed there for a month, but I was doing it every day.
Okay.
So, when I came back and I had Indian food because of the masala and stuff,
right.
my I got major acidity. So, I had to slowly ease into it. So, I was doing salads every day
right.
for a while. Yeah. So,
that covers your diet. It's simple.
Yeah, it's very simple.
So,
eat what you feel like.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Eat what you feel like.
You simplified it, yes.
Yeah.
And what about the heat from others? Your parents were supportive, of course, then you don't give a damn about what people think. But
yeah.
still, you have to come on a public platform and you have
yeah.
to convince other girls that, okay, this is cool, you should
yeah.
do that. Was that a challenge?
Not really.
Because you had friends and it came on social media and then it became...
Yeah, you know, like I tell a lot of people, even if I get random Insta messages from guys...
Right.
It's always...
Name one. Not name the guy, but you know...
No, they're never weird. They're always like, ma'am, what you're doing is amazing.
Really?
Ma'am, your strength is amazing.
Like, I'm sure there are a few guys.
And I've never got one...
Bob Baji, no?
No. I'm like, wow, respect for these Indian guys. Like...
Yeah.
You know, but it's like, it's as if they are understanding that
it's
this is
happen.
Hard and this is fitness.
Yeah.
And
sure.
I don't have that strength, she does. And they respect that. And that's really amazing.
They
so thank you guys.
They should. But it's social media at the end. Once you get big, which you are going to get eventually. So you'll get all kinds of people.
I'm sure.
Then you
block.
Yeah. Yeah, just keep your fucking phone.
Block.
Yeah.
So, you know.
I was really interested to know what kind of messages are you
getting. I know, but
yeah.
I don't get any of those. I did get one call once because WhatsApp Pune had featured my classes.
Right.
So my number was out there and I got a call once that very night saying, Madam, pole dance? I said, huh. Pole dance classes hote. So he said, nahi, aur pole dancing hota hai?
What did he mean? Like,
I think he meant to come and watch.
Perform,
yeah.
Perform. Oh.
So then
I don't blame that guy.
No, I don't.
Yeah.
I explained to him that this is a fitness class hai, ladkiyon ke liye.
Right.
Aur,
please do that right now. So that we also send a message across.
Yeah.
The difference. And I don't personally think even the other side is wrong. But when it gets, you know, it gets dirty when pimps are involved.
Exactly.
Then it gets dirty, right? Then it gets dirty.
Yeah.
But I want you to take it over from like this very moment and just explain the whole concept. Like pole dancing, exotic, stripping.
Yeah, so pole dance has different areas.
Right.
There's exotic dancing,
right.
Okay, which a lot of people do, guys and girls. Then there
what Demi did in striptease is...
Yeah, that's like exotic.
But she was
also...
Was she a hooker in that movie? She was just a stripper.
Yeah,
stripper.
She was a stripper.
Not a hooker,
she
but a stripper.
She was a stripper.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, and so see, the strippers are the ones who got pole dancing
they
popular.
They put it there, yeah.
Even if... so some believe it, some don't. I believe that it pole dance has its roots in Mallakhambh. The only reason I believe it is because now that I learn Mallakhambh, I see the moves are the same.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, and this was there before.
Right.
So, the moves are absolutely the same. Only the grips are slightly different because the pole width is different. It's a wooden pole, etc.
Right.
And, but essentially, so I think the roots are there. But the strippers popularized pole dancing in the West.
Right.
Yeah. And now it's become a form of fitness because there are fitness professionals who do it.
Right.
Yeah, there are physiotherapists specially for pole, you know, abroad.
Yeah.
So that's the pole sport and the pole fitness part of it.
Right.
So the dancing, I feel, comes into play for me when I'm doing spin pole.
Right.
So there's static pole and spin pole.
Hmm.
On static, your body moves around the pole. On spin, you need to transition and hold your poses.
Okay.
So there's nothing like this is easier than the other.
Right.
Yeah, because holding a pose, holding a move is very difficult.
Yeah.
Yeah, and when you use momentum on static, it does get easier, but then doing different transitions is really hard.
And how do they, like the spins?
Yeah.
How,
so when the poles...
Physics, like pure physics.
Yeah,
like
so when the
pole
spins,
like
it's like your merry-go-rounds.
Right.
If you're close to the pole, it'll spin fast.
And if you shut your body, you'll even...
Spin really fast.
Yeah.
And so to control the pole... We
expand. Okay.
We extend our bodies.
Right.
Maybe open the legs out or whatever.
So that's where the synchronization comes in. So you
extend
your body slowly to.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Nice.
It's right. So. So while the pole is doing the work, but you should control the pole, not the other way around. Because if you let the pole control you, it can go out of control.
Sweet.
Yeah, and you do feel dizzy after spin pole. Some girl, I still do sometimes. I've thrown up after spin pole. Yeah.
Okay.
Of doing, you know, because when you're constantly spinning and stuff.
Right.
Yeah. That's happened once, but yeah.
Okay. So that's, and what's the response of women when you open four poles? Like,
it was, so I got bullied into teaching by a few people I know.
Really?
So I started at home.
Uh-huh.
I had one pole in my tiny bedroom.
What do you mean bullied? As in by people
please
who
teach,
used...
Please teach, please teach. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, like that, like that.
Like that. I didn't, it wasn't on my mind to teach.
Right.
Maybe I had thought of it at some point where I should teach, but then it's just like, I don't know if I'll be a good teacher. It requires a lot of patience.
Yeah.
Am I good enough to teach? You know, all these questions do come in because you've never really done it. So I started teaching people I know, like friends.
Mm.
They would come home and I would do one-on-one classes. And I realized I'm good at this and they're learning really well.
Right.
And since I've trained under different instructors, I've sort of incorporated the best from all.
Mm-hmm.
So I know how to explain a move, how to break it down. I know how to spot, you know, and I know the kind of attention a student needs to feel secure enough to do a move.
That's
because
important.
I've been there, done that. I'm still there.
Right.
I still train.
Right.
You're always a student. So, yeah, with word of, I've never really gone out there and advertised it, but with word of mouth, the students kept increasing because like say you would see like, oh my God, she's doing amazing stuff. I want to do that too. I want to learn. So it just kept increasing. And then I realized like now I can't stick to one-on-one because then it was draining my energy.
Right.
So I decided to just put up more polls and get more girls in at one time.
Right.
And it's really nice. We
it's
have
growing.
A lot of fun.
I can see that it's growing.
It's growing.
Yeah.
Yeah. I have 5 poles now. So 4 poles now has 5 poles.
Okay.
Yeah. But yeah, the girls are loving it. We have a lot of fun in classes. Each one helps the other. It's like a close community. Yeah, it's good.
I don't know whether that's the right term, but you know, brotherhood and...
Yeah, sisterhood.
I don't want to
right
say
now,
sisterhood. Right now, because bro is a universal term. Right? Even girls call each other
bro.
Bro.
Yeah,
so it's like more of a brotherhood over there.
Yeah. So I have got inquiries from guys as well who want to come in.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm waiting for that. I really want to see guys in India. If it was so difficult for girls, for guys to come out, that would be amazing.
But you
that'd
know, guys
amazing.
Come and do it.
Yeah.
It'll not be that, that stigma goes away then. It's like both are doing it.
Yeah.
You know, people's minds will open up more, I feel.
For that, I think...
It's really sad that I have to say that, but I
no,
think
no,
that
no.
would
I
help.
I think you should say that again and again because at the end, the awareness matters, right?
Yeah.
If even after 5 years, people will still think that I have to do girly moves on the pole.
Exactly.
Men, they will never show up, right?
Yeah.
But if they see some men doing flags and all that stuff, they are spinning.
Of course,
even if they
where you invert on the pole.
Yeah, do all
that
stuff.
Yeah.
So if you teach that, I think you should talk about it more and more.
Yeah.
Start.
So I had a student's husband. I've not posted it yet. I am going to. He was very sporting enough to say, yeah, go ahead and post it. We have a video of how difficult a simple move, like just, it's called crucifix.
Okay.
Holding the pole between your legs and being upright was for him. And he plays football.
Okay.
So it's not that he's not fit or whatever. He's really fit.
But he hasn't trained those muscles, right? So
exactly.
Yeah, yeah.
And also pole burns is a thing.
Right.
You know, it's not easy to grab the pole. And withstand that pain.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
In that free class that you're offering, I'll come and record videos.
Yes, please.
Behind the...
Yeah,
I won't grab the pole because of the burns.
So, my husband, I train him sometimes as well.
Right.
So, he comes for Mallakhambh with me.
Right.
So, for him also grabbing even the Mallakhambh pole, he's like, I hate it because of the burn. He's like, how do you deal with it?
Yeah.
But other stuff, the strength moves where you're inverting, he loves that. That gives him a high, you know, like, and he feels his core strength going up.
I think that's the main difference. Okay, people might come and say, I might get heat for what I'm going to say.
Yeah.
And because I said girls and guys are like, I don't think so.
No,
I
they're
personally
so different.
Don't, they're so different. So, so, you know, guys have a way of expressing themselves and it's more testosterone based.
Yeah.
They are very aggressive, you know, rash driving, throttling your bike,
all of that.
Or, you know, when a girl comes being all alpha and all, these are traits that men have.
Exactly,
usually. Same, and that's purely evolutionary, you know, displaying your masculinity. At the end, it's all about getting the perfect mate, right? Evolution.
Exactly.
I think that works for girls as well.
Yeah.
But their way of expressing feminine, if I'm saying that word right, I always fucking hate the femininity. If they are expressing femininity, they have this, you know, I won't call, you know, nakhre because that gets artificial. But but they have this way, adai will be a right word. And I think it's very powerful and dance is the best way to express it.
Yeah.
I don't know whether you agree, but dance and pole has taken it to another level.
Yeah,
and
really.
It has just leveled up.
Yeah, it has.
So if you say that, that's why guys, men, if they come and they want to do poles, they might not, you know, do the spins or all
that. But I have guys coming to try. So
the graceful moves.
They try the spins because even holding your body up in a chair spin is so hard. And they're like, how are you staying up? How are you staying up? So they want to know, how am I staying up with just my hands?
That's amazing.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Yeah. So it's,
And Mallakhambh is like, were you like, aware of Mallakhambh before pole?
So I was always aware of Mallakhambh.
Yeah.
And I always tell my parents, why didn't you all...
It's a hardcore Indian thing, right?
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
Like, and men only used to do that earlier.
Yeah, it someone told me like only men do it, but...
It started because I haven't seen...
Women doing the pole Mallakhambh.
Yeah,
women
yeah.
do rope Mallakhambh.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, not a lot of women do pole Mallakhambh. But there are women who do pole. I mean, I'm there. There's Teja.
Yeah.
So, actually, I started Mallakhambh because of my pole student, Teja, who is also my yoga teacher.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sweet.
So, she actually told me that she also does Mallakhambh and she's loving it.
Right.
So she's like, why don't you also try it? And I was like, why not?
Yeah.
I took Ashwin, I bullied him into it.
Right.
And we went and he hated the first class because of the burns. I loved it and I begged him, give it one more chance.
Okay.
I literally begged him. Like
yeah.
in the car, it was begging and fighting. Like, you can't do this much for me and this and that. So he's like, I'll come for one more class and that's
yeah.
it. But the next class he
what
came.
What got him hooked?
The not gripping, the, you know, the sir also understood, like, this guy doesn't
yeah, yeah.
like the burns.
Yeah.
So he made him do shoulder mounts and
upper
climb.
Body work.
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
And Ash was like, oh, yeah, now I can do this.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm not such a dud. Like,
right.
yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
So I can do what she does.
Perfect.
So some moves he's better than me as well.
Sure. That's where the strength,
just a couple of moves.
Strength comes in play,
yeah.
right? You know, men
but
are.
But just
obviously.
A couple of
moves. I'm sure. I'm sure. I don't doubt that even one bit.
So, yeah.
Anyway,
but yeah,
that was awesome.
Yeah.
So, what's besides poles? Like, you know, what else? I know journalism, but you don't continue that anymore, right?
No, I was a journalist for 11 and a half years.
For Times of India?
No, I worked with all the publications in Pune.
More like freelance?
No, I was on, like, I started when I was 16.
Okay.
So, that time I freelanced with Indian Express
right.
for 3 years. Then I was on the payroll with Sakal Times Maharashtra
Sakal,
Herald.
Yeah.
Yeah, Maharashtra Herald at that point. Then I again worked with Indian Express. And then, Times of India.
Sweet, sweet. But
yeah.
not planning to do that because I don't know.
No, so
there.
I sort of, I don't miss it.
Yeah.
I miss writing sometimes maybe. But I don't miss the job because I think I did it for too long. And being in Pune, it was getting a bit repetitive for me. I speak only for myself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And for a million others.
No, only for myself.
But
because I was into feature writing and stuff.
Okay.
And I just felt, so like, you know, maybe not even repetitive. Let's just say there was this restlessness in me.
Kira, we call it Kira.
Yeah. So I have this thing since childhood. My family makes a lot of fun of me. Like, oh, she'll always start something and stop.
Right.
Yeah, it's always.
I think that's a process of figuring out who you are.
Who you are
yeah.
and what you really love.
Yeah. yeah.
And like I told you before, and I repeat myself with pole, it's like I was whatever I was doing, I was constantly looking beyond to find that one thing that I love.
Yeah.
And with pole, it's my soul has just found it.
Yeah, I
you
understand.
Know,
I understand what you're talking about.
Yeah, it's like there's nothing else I want or
yeah.
need.
And
I don't need to look now.
Right, right.
This is it.
I understand that feeling.
Yeah.
That's that connection. It's sad that many people don't find it.
Yeah.
And they don't. And they don't. Some don't even try. Some accept defeat.
Yeah.
But it's really important to find that. It's
yeah.
really important.
Yeah. And I would say keep looking. And when you find it, just give it all you can.
Right.
You know, to build on that passion.
Yes.
And just see where you can go.
You know, why don't people do it? Because I think it's a gamble at the end of the day, right?
Of course.
Risk is involved.
Of course.
People don't want to leave that safe zone.
Of course. You know,
so
like,
you
say
job,
I'm lucky.
Yeah.
You know, I'm coming from a place where I could...
I wouldn't say that. I'll say that you are strong and decisive and you have balls to do that.
Yeah.
If that
and
makes
I
sense.
And I have
yeah.
Ashwin. I told you, I give him the credit. I did not have the balls to do it.
I will still not give him pura credit because
yeah.
it was
yeah.
your decision.
Yeah,
at the end,
I know.
It's all, so after
yeah.
20 years, you can, you know, be whatever you want.
Yeah.
It's the decision that you, the main decision that you took right now will,
yeah.
you know, lead
exactly.
to that. I will give 99% credit to you, but 1% yeah, family and all they can take. Sure, support
yeah.
is important.
Yeah.
But sometimes, what if you did not get the support? I'm just saying, what if you did not get the support? Maybe you are the kind who will be like, fuck it, I'm going to do it
yeah,
anyway.
Yeah, I would have rebelled. I'm a rebel.
See, so I don't
I would,
think
yeah.
it's
yeah.
like, you shouldn't give credit, I say.
Yeah,
you should
I know, I know.
It makes sense. You should
yeah.
tell them that you've been a support, a help.
Yeah.
And they should understand this.
Yeah.
It's you at the end of the day.
That's true.
Yeah. But, I mean,
true.
You're a nice
yeah.
person, you're sweet. And I'm sure your husband is amazing.
He is. I wish he was here today. The dogs are home. So, yeah.
Right.
But, you know, I also feel, of course, we all find everything at the right time that we're supposed
yes.
to. I believe in that. And we are at the right time, at the right, you know, everything works out at that point.
Universe.
Yeah, but if only I'd looked harder pehle, because see, I had my brother at home who was such an inspiration with fitness, and I took him for granted. Like, it's like he's doing such amazing stuff. I don't want to go to the gym. Gym is not for me. Gym is boring.
Yeah.
I don't want to lift weights. I was like that, you know, and I'm just like, shit, if I would have started training with Dhruv much earlier, I would have been so much more stronger maybe right now. But we would not know. We wouldn't know.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Maybe pole nahi aata beech mein.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe.
It's all, you know.
Yeah.
I don't think it's okay to look back and say ye kiya hota, but it doesn't matter.
I know, but I'm waiting to jam with him, like do a pole jam with him. Yeah, he's, you know, he's,
I've seen a few pictures you guys do.
Yeah, but I want to put it on record, he's not yet come to my studio.
Right.
He hasn't seen it. He hasn't.
The very reason he's not gonna come is the same reason I'm not gonna come, if you know what I mean, right?
No, so he's just lazy to come to that side of town.
I have spoken to that guy. I know that guy. I can relate to it. The very reason he won't go on that pole is the reason why.
I'm going to make him and you.
He's going to do
that. I want to do a double flag with him.
But I've seen that Italy picture where you, the sibling thing, that you both are flagging. There's something. Yeah.
I didn't go to Italy with him.
Oh shit, was it his girlfriend? No, I don't know.
No, she doesn't flag. It was just him. Dhruv and I have a picture in a park over here in Pune.
It might not be Italy, but you guys are flagging, right?
No, I didn't flag. I did another move.
But, you know, it was on the
pole. I couldn't flag at that time.
Okay.
But yeah, I want to do like my version of the human flag with his,
right,
him. I think that'll be really amazing.
Sure.
To do pole doubles and work together. So, yeah.
Sweet.
Hopefully so.
A message, anything that you want to share. Anything that you feel like talking about?
Because pole has changed my life so much,
right.
I want more people to take to it. I want to share it with more people, be it a guy or a girl, and be it a 40-year-old, a 60-year-old, or a 20-year-old.
Okay.
There is no upper age limit for pole.
Mm.
You don't have to be strong to join pole. Like, I have a lot of people saying that I'm trying to become strong so that I can come for pole. No, I was not strong when I did pole.
Yeah.
I became strong because of pole.
Right.
So, I want more people to get there, because fitness and good health is everything. It's more important than anything. And another thing I want to say is that even if you don't pole and you have your own fitness journey, do not compare yourself with someone else. I cannot be you. You cannot be me.
Yeah.
And just enjoy your journey. Keep pushing yourself. Keep pushing your body beyond the limits your mind sets. And see what you can achieve and celebrate each victory.
Sweet.
Yeah. That's what I do.
Yeah. Thanks, Abul.
Thank you.
It was crazy good. I had fun.
Thank you. So did I.
Cheers.
Yes. Thanks. Cheers.